What's up, YouTubers? Today we're going to take a look at the Steel Will Scylla. It is Scylla, not Scylla, I believe, because that is the pronunciation, and I had to watch a lot of videos and read a lot of the Greek sea monster in mythology, or Greek mythology sea monster. So I'm going to go with Scylla for this one, even though I had been calling it Scylla. This is, in fact, a top flipper with thumb studs, unusually, but it does definitely make for one of the pros of this particular blade. This blade is a 3.5-inch hunk of D2 steel. The knife weighs in at 4.4 honking ounces, and the price is $60. So, as far as comparisons go, I'm going to go ahead and first show some functional comparisons. And for myself, I kind of really thought of, in terms of blade shape, D2 steel, and similar price, I was looking at the Kershaw copper matrix in this case. Though this is the medium-sized one, there is a full-size matrix that has a full 3.5-inch blade. This one just has 3.25-inch. And then also I thought about the cold steel Airlight. This is a $72 knife, so similar in price, probably similar in function. Of course, this particular one is the tanto blade, but they also sell that in the drop point too. So, at $60, that being the $72 knife that I got, and this one I think was like 64, I think those would be kind of some similar comparisons in terms of use out there, especially if you're looking in that price range, and some knives that definitely can take a fair bit of abuse, like the size of this. In terms of the next comparison I want to make of this particular knife, it actually has the unique distinction of kind of not only looking like a rocket ship here, but it's one of the few knives that I have that also stands completely vertical on a flat surface. So the other comparison knife, as far as that goes, I'm going to go ahead and put up the Wee Banter in there, and then also the CRKT CEO. So just kind of a little novelty in terms of the capabilities to stand absolutely on end. An unusual feature for a knife. Let's jump right into the pros of this knife. It's definitely very fidget fun and unique. It's not often that you have that sort of thing. You can use the edge of your finger to whack that thing open. That's kind of unusual on a knife. And so like that, definitely very fidgety. It is definitely with heavier use as usable for heavier use. I was definitely kind of beaten on this, and it's very substantial in the hand. A small handle, but it does fit four full fingers of medium large hand there, and it definitely is a little bit thick blade stop for slicing well, but it definitely cuts well, and being the D2 steel can take quite a beating this particular edge. I also do like how they Steel Will actually does a really good job with their black washing of their blades and then the liners on this one, so that's actually kind of one of the other good things about this one. Very beefy liners as well, by the way. They're extremely strong, and I have no doubt this can definitely is designed to take a little bit more abuse. It is very comfortable in the hand, many different grips, no problem on any pull cuts there. If you go back around in the murder position or ice pick position, that's definitely a good, nice comfort in the hand. So there goes a pretty good. It has an extremely glassy return, but I do want to add a little bit of a note to that. Is it took a little bit of coaxing and maintenance on this particular knife, and so we'll talk about that in the cons. But once you had a chance to do a little maintenance on it, it's very glassy on return. And then the last thing I wanted to point out is that it is a it does have tip up right hand and left hand carry is one of the pros on this. Though it doesn't have an inset there, you can see up in the corner here that they actually send a pocket clip, since this is kind of contoured to go around with it, the pocket clip. And it's functional, not super deep, but I don't actually mind having a little bit of a hand grab on there. And it's not like a whole lot of sticking out of your pocket. You have a little chunk there. So in terms of that, I definitely consider that a positive, especially the fact that it was kind of designed in there with that curvature. But they went ahead and send you that extra pocket clip, so not a bad thing. On the cons, the detent is just a little bit light. Let's see if I can shake this out. It took a little bit of a hitting, but it does shake out a little bit easy. And I think that's not that because the detent is terrible. I think it's just such a heavy blade, and the way that it is hooked in there, you can kick this out. So I'm not afraid of this opening up in my pocket or anything. I mean, it takes a fair bit of whack, but I still think that detent is too light. Over here, where the external stop pins and thumb studs, basically flip out, you are gonna pinch, and that's just gonna simply happen. Well, your fingers are gonna get in there when you're flipping it, and that thing definitely catches and it kind of hurts. So that little pinch point right there, I definitely consider that one of the cons. I'm not sure how to avoid that. Maybe they could have moved it a little bit further forward. I'm not sure, with some of the design on this. One of the good things also about this, sorry, go back there, is that you do have a nice extra second set of really defense against this thing unlocking, is that you have your thumb over that extension there. It's almost like a friction folder in that sense, where it holds it into place. So that pinch point, definitely a negative on this particular knife. And the last thing is, there was an absolute mountain of grease slash Vaseline inside the pivot on this thing, so that literally after about four flips, everything in the pivot just came loose, and this blade just went all the way to the edge to where it was rubbing metal. Tightened it up, then I tried to clean out with just a Q-tip. Didn't want to have to do too much maintenance right out of the gate, but I actually did have to completely disassemble this knife, and there was a mountain of Vaseline everywhere. And it was also actually interfering with that return, which, like I said, it returns extremely well now, this particular knife. So that was just kind of disappointing. It was very lazy, and I didn't appreciate that for this. So, and then last thing is, it's a series of design. I won't call them flaws because they're choices, but they could have really turned this into something super badass. So the first and foremost, the clip really looks like it's smashed in. If you take a look at that, and at first I thought mine had gotten bent until I looked at the backup one that they gave you, or for the left side up, and it also has that bend too. I think if they had just straightened that out, it would have actually looked kind of beautiful. They could have even put a little outside curvature on that. So that's a design problem, I think. Also, the double wide thumb studs, they stick out from the knife. They're unnecessary for deployment. This thing would have been fine if they had just cut those in half the size. Like, for example, if you just kind of cover those up, they could have gotten by, because that's the only part necessary to really lock this thing up against those liners there. And you didn't need that. It just kind of sticks out and is a little bit fat and lazy for my part. I thought for this particular edition, and by the way, they do have the there is a blue scale version still available at Knife Center as of the making of this video. But I don't mind the color accents, but if somebody's going for a murdered out version and they have that nice black wash, and they even black wash the liners, in that instance, I think it's a bad choice, because the blue scaled one actually has a black, I guess, anodized aluminum backspacer, just like this. It's just black, and I really would have preferred that. Because I thought it was kind of pretty awesome to have the blacked out version, and I just think that that would have been better for this particular model. And then the last thing is the release wedge. When I was cutting, it just doesn't go far enough. It actually worked fairly well for such a fat stock, but as soon as you get to this very thick area here, because there is no additional release wedge, it really kind of it guides where you're going to cut, and you don't guide it, so it's not so good as far as that goes. And also, and I was thinking about functionally, maybe they put that in for your thumb, but if you look at this functionally, you're only going up to about 3/4 of an inch away from there. They could have taken this wedge all the way up to there, and it would have been a much better slicer, slash cutter on this particular one. So again, it kind of nitpicks on design, but I would love to work with them on this one, and I think we could make this into an amazing knife, truly. Overall, I'd say it's a tad gimmicky, this knife, the Scylla, but it still works. And certainly, as a heavy user that's not super expensive, you can beat it up, scratch it up. And like I said, the black wash comes off a little bit, but that's good. That's part of the use of a decent knife, that you can beat up. So I think, as far as that goes, it works really well. Would I have rather had a chance to make some design choices, thin out the blade stock and a few other things, nest the liners, just that, yeah, would add some cost, but we go to a better stainless steel maybe in the D2, and for $100, this particular knife and the design would be not only gimmicky and very fidget friendly, but I think would be an awesome knife. So hope you enjoyed this and it was worth your time. If so, like and subscribe, and have a great day. Take care now.